Hello and welcome to Red Stapler Channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a water ripple effect from scratch using JavaScript and pixi.js library in just a couple minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. Pixi.js is a 2D WebGL JavaScript library that lets you create lots of stunning effects easily with just a few lines of code. First, let's start with download the latest version of pixi.js and include it to your page. And here is the example page. The only CSS we need for this tutorial is margin 0 and overflow hidden. Now let's start with initializing pixi.js. First, we need to create an application. An application object has necessary components to render your scene like renderer, root container, and time tracking. This is the fastest way to start using pixi unless you want to manually create them one by one. I'm going to supply our current viewport width and height as the size. Then add the scene to our HTML page as canvas element using app.view. And next, we'll start with adding image to the scene. First, let's create a sprite from JPG image. Then set width and height. And then add it to the stage. Now to create the ripple effect, we need to move the image pixels away from their original position to create a distortion. With pixi.js, this can be done with displacement map. Basically, you just create a random variation of black and white pattern and use it to map with original image. For this tutorial, I'm going to use Photoshop to create one. First, create a new square image. Then use render filter and select cloud. And that's it, that's all you need. Now I'm going to create a sprite from this image. Then create a displacement filter from the sprite. We need to set the wrap mode to repeat. This is to make sure that the displacement covers the entire image. Then add it to the stage and apply the filter. At this point, everything is ready, but still you won't see much of the difference. We need to create an animation to move the displacement map to be able to see the ripple effect. Let's create an animate function and move the displacement map position. At the end of the function, we will call requestAnimationFrame to start the animation loop. Okay, that looks pretty good. But if you look a little bit closer, you will see a distortion around the edge. This is normal because we don't have any pixel beyond that. We can fix it by zooming in a little bit. Just apply the transform scale to the renderer. Also, I think the ripple is a little bit too dense, so I'm going to scale the displacement map too. You can try, change, and experiment with different displacement maps to create various ripple effects. And that's it, just a bit over 20 lines of code for this tutorial. Hope you guys enjoy, and if you love to see more of this, don't forget to like or subscribe to stay tuned with us. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye!